Welcome to Let's Play Forza Motorsport 4 Part 40. And for this segment, I'm going to be at least attempting to use my Celine S5S Raptor that I bought. Did I buy this? I think I bought it, because it's not tuned up to a thing. Yeah, I bought this. How the fuck much was this? I don't remember, so I'm going to go over here and, 180,000. Okay. Cool. Alright. So, let's just go to the upgrade shop, do a quick upgrade, get this at the top of S-Class, because I'm a fucking bitch, and, well, that's just it, because I'm a fucking bitch, so, you know. So, here we go. Got my S5S Raptor, S698. And let's do our next race in the World Tour. It is going to be at Catalunya, and I'm going to do the Supercar Open. So, round 19 of the championship series we go. Hey, boy. So, yeah, stuff. It's been confirmed that it might come out. So it's not actually confirmed that there's going to be a remaster. Is that what you're saying here? Or at least attempting to say, I don't fucking know. Anyways, let's look at the starting grid. Yeah, you know, supercar grid. Let's go. Okay, attempt 3. Because I am absolute garbage at driving this car. And not crashing into everyone. Fuck. Okay. Well, I don't really need to push all that hard because this thing is very capable of, like, winning. I just need to not die to death. Get around and away from Esposito as soon as possible, because Esposito can fucking choke on the largest cock in the universe. Fuck Esposito. Okay, now. Nice and smooth. Nice and smooth. Don't have to apologize, I'm just saying. I do not take tips unless I specifically ask for them, which I almost never do. I play the games the way I want to play them. Having people say, oh, you should do this to the car is just something I'm like, no. I don't want to do that to the car, else I would have. Anyways, hello Rossi. Goodbye, Rossi. Down to third you go. Whoa, hey now. Someone, where are you going, Rossi? That's not where the track goes. The fuck you doing, boy? Oh, see Alex. Oh shit. Okay, well, I'm in this situation again where I'm right behind Miller, but this time my car is actually fucking clean. I don't know how, but it is. No mechanical damage whatsoever. That is a fool. Alrighty. So anyways, one lap down, 3 to go. I have just one car to pass. My car is in good shape. Somehow. So, I just need to be patient with this pass on Muller and not do shit like rear-end him. Out of nowhere. Try to brake early so I don't ram into his ass. Under braking, because I'm really good about doing that. Really fucking good about doing that. I'd rather not do that. Okay. Just, set up a pass maybe off of this turn. I'm thinking, you know, outbreaking him into the hairpin here. Although I'm kind of far away. Yep, yeah, nope, not going for it. Bailing out. Too far away for that. Hopefully I can get a good run out of this last turn. Maybe outbreak him into turn one. That'd be nice. I'm not even sure who has the power advantage here. I mean, I'm pushing almost 800 horsepower. I think I have the advantage here. Not by much, though. Not by much. Ooh. Okay, we're good. Everything's fine. And we are in the lead. I just gotta hold it for the rest of this race. Which hopefully won't be too hard to do. Shouldn't be too hard to do. As long as I can fucking keep this car on the road. Was kind of sketchy. I did a lot of steering correction. Car's pretty cool looking. I like it. Please make the hairpin. Oh god, okay, I barely made it. Fool. Moving on. How often do I stream? Usually on my nights off from work. I stream. I haven't been doing a good job at that this week because I've just been so goddamn tired. And then again, that's pretty much how I am at all times anymore. It's just I'm so goddamn tired. So fucking tired. Karma driving. This is the Chevrolet Corvette C8. Haha. Anyways, no. It's a Celine S5S Raptor. Ooh. Good. Everything's fine. Nice and smooth. Got a comfortable gap on Muller here. Don't need to push too hard now. It's gonna break very early from this hairpin because I can. Shit. Okay, we're good. And off the final turn, and there we go. Three tries later. Win the race in much less interesting fashion than the failed attempts, but hey, whatever. Shit happens. So, there we go. I win. So let's just... Oh, okay. Well then. Game had a little bit of a sad moment. Sabine Infinity. Didn't get a driver level up though, unfortunately. So no new car for me. Let's just move on to race number 2 of this segment. Event 20 overall in this series.
You're on your way back to Italy to test your luck on the Mugello Autodromo Internazionale.
Okay, Mugello we go. And just because I still don't want to upgrade this thing to Arc 3 class, I guess we're just going to do another supercar race. Say, same opposition and stuff. That's cool, yeah. I guess. And thus begins the yawning. Anyways, Mugello. For fun times at Mugello. Because Mugello. That's all I got, because Mugello. Mugello, Mugello, Mugello. Mugello. Starting grid, same as last race, so off we go. Hopefully I can actually win this on the first try. Unlike at Catalunya. Let's find out. The epic burnout to start. Cause, you know, 800 horse Esposito, I swear to God. Fucking Esposito. Trying to ruin my day. Whoa, car! What the hell was that? It's like, hi, I'm just gonna oversteer. No, we're not in Carview. Oh, quit bitching. In Carview is good. And you know how I do it. I alternate between race. Alternate between chase cam and interior view each race. Quit smashing fucking Evans's ass. Whoa, hey. This is way too tight of racing for me because I am awful at racing around even one car, let alone three. You just stay behind me, Rossi. I saw you almost hitting my ass because I was way, way early on the brakes. Kind of taking it easy here. Don't mind me. Okay. Lap one complete, got a little bit of damage, but not much, compared to what's been happening with this car. Say 3/4 of a medium pizza, because you hate yourself. Get on my level, I eat 3/4 of a large pizza every time I get one. Therefore, I hate myself more, haha, anyways. You haven't reached my level of self-hatred. And we are diving underneath Miller. Not exactly in the turn I was expecting to dive. But hey, whatever. And it didn't work anyway, so... Now we're gonna do the dive on the turn I expected to do the dive. Raw her. There we go, and P1 we go. Alright, now let's pretend to know that... Or, let's pretend that I know how to drive this thing. Keep the lead for the last 2.5 laps. Corner of my eye on the mirror. Don't mirror drive, but you know, be mindful of or be aware of how close Mueller is. I am kind of inching away from him, so you know, won't have to worry about my mirror for long, unless I outbrake myself like I kind of did there. Son of a bitch. Okay, I guess I have to run off the turn, so that's good. See Rossi being very aggressive. Yeah, he's kind of busy trying to control a big-ass fucking all-wheel drive Lambo. Get him in a car that he can actually control well. He's forced to be reckoned with. But an all-wheel drive Lambo, not so much. Whether it be the Reventon or Murcielago, or is it Gallardo? I can't even fucking remember. They all look the same. So it's just like, eh. I'm going to upshift this time. For no reason! And then almost go flying off and... off the track into the fucking gravel. Yeah, when Ross is in some hard control, he's all over the place, like the Reventon and fucking Bugatti Veyron. Rossi attempting to drive the Veyron is kind of hilarious, because he drives it about how a Bugatti is driven, straight. Can't fucking turn it or slow it down. Drive a yellow bird. If only the yellow bird was in this game. And before it is, and I'm stupid. Ooh. Gotta be careful avoiding that wheel spin, yo. Oh, the yellow bird's DLC. Ew. Okay. Let's show how much I remember of this game. Anyways, final lap. I'm braking super early, which puts Mueller right on my ass, but I don't care. Oh shit. Almost lost it there. We're good, everything's fine. We're A-okay. Hmm. This Forza 4 made. This game was released in 2011. Yeah, 2011. Oh, fucking goddamn it. No. Bad. Very, very bad. Okay, kept the lead, we're fine. Fucking almost blew away there in the last turn, but we're fine. And I win. Alright. I'm having troubles, difficulty of this car. Yes, no. I'm having difficulty driving this car. Not surprising, since this is big power thing. At least I won that on my first try, so, you know, that's good and stuff. Yay, level 3 affinity. Alright, next race in our Raptor. Possibly. So here we go.
For today's event, we return to the historic Road America track. In Extreme Multiclass, finish first in your group while sharing the track with another group of very different cars.
Okay, I'm not going to be driving the Raptor in this race because I kind of have to use a GT2 car, so... So I guess back into the Ford GT we go, because that's the only GT2 class car I own, apparently. Hooray. So, off to Road America we go. For the slight diversion to the Raptor drive. And yeah. But hey, Road America, it's a cool track, so. What was this race? GT2 versus GT1, I think, yeah. It's gonna be a grand old time, and I'm probably gonna fuck everything up, because that's usually what I do, but. Habaday. So let's see, we got... Well, I am going to be racing against the rejects, so... It'll probably be an easy victory for me. Let's find out. Plus, I'm going to be starting on pole in my class. Because that's how multi-class race goes. Races goes. So here we go. I'm off the launch. And clear of Rousseau! Thank you. Whoever that was, thank you for destroying the front of my car. Appreciate it, my dude. Oh well. It's definitely gonna affect me, but it shouldn't affect me too much. I mean, Rousseau might actually be a threat, but, you know. Hello, Rousseau, being a threat. How are you? Wow, no cheeky dive there. I'm actually surprised. That's like their big diving spot on me. Throughout the entire Forza series. Not just this track alone. Cars ahead are GT1 class cars. This is a multi-class race. It's GT1 cars up in front of me, and then I'm leading the GT2 field right now. So I only have to worry about the 5 fuckers behind me. Ooh, hey Rousseau, how you doing? Yeah, I saw your nose there. That was damn close. Well, you don't have to fucking... It's okay, you don't have to, like, try to think of something to say in chat. Just sit back and enjoy the stream. Enjoy me being an asshole to everybody in the world. OK, Okay, this is where my damage is actually fucking me over. Oh, I got 3 laps, so it's fine. Hello, Russo. Let's just slipstream Russo here. Yeah. I thought I was breaking late enough for a stupid cheeky dive, but no, I was not. Which works for me, because, you know, we would have just collided at the apex, because we would have, you know, not reacted in time. Fuck my ass. Because I need more understeer. Just get behind me, Russo. Stop trying. I'd love to see Adelaide in more games. Adelaide's like one of my favorite Aussie tracks. Of course, you know, Mount Panorama is my favorite track in the world, so forever be second banana to the mountain. But Adelaide is fucking awesome, and I like it a lot, and wish it was in more games. Do I plan to play Pro Street at some point? Yes, I do. But I have some other Need for Speed games I have to tackle before that. Okay. Lap 2. Other than the additional damage, overall went better than lap 1. I'm actually going to be kind of glad when I finish this marathon. Because, I'll get to play fucking DuckyTLP games from other franchises finally. Anyways. As much as I love Forza. Fucking. I'd be glad to play something else. Oh no, do not go into the grass, car. That is not allowed. We do not do it, son of a bitch. Okay, we're good. Had enough grip to get back on the road immediately. Thank God. Yeah. Okay, I carried way too much speed through that turn. Good job, me. 10 out of 10. Just fucking flying through the turn without a care. Okay, final lap. Got this. I can hear Russo lurking behind me. I just barely faintly hear the is Ferrari's engine. Which, considering I have my headphones on right now and am listening to music, I'm hearing his engine on a 3-second delay, but potato potato. Yeah. Come on, get around this damn carousel. Corners to go. Nice and smooth in the Canada corner. A little too slow through Canada corner, but it's whatever. Alright, gain a little time through that turn as I do. And a little wide around the final turn, but it's fine, and I have a big enough gap, so it doesn't matter. So, cross the line, there we go. I win. I win in my slightly wounded car. So, while the others cross the line, let's see how the GT1 race went down. Wow, Brown finished second, nice. What a badass. Hey, Fisher finally made it across the line. It took him forever. Alright. That's another race down. Hopefully we can go back into our Celine for next events, and, yeah.
It'll be fun. Holy crap.
Today you'll get back on track at Northamptonshire, England's Silverstone Racing Circuit.
Okay, more Silverstone. Sure. Alright. Back into the Raptor. Where the hell is it? There you are. And Class S Euro Tour it is, because I don't want to upgrade this thing to R3. Just because. So, it's time for round 22 of the Championship Series. Off to Silverstone we go. Silverstone. Don't like that Ferrari livery. What, the Krohn Racing livery? The green? Because, hey, Krohn Racing. Yeah. It's alright.
Not a fan of the green. But,
excuse me. Okay. Here's the starting lineup. Let's race. Yes, England. If only it wasn't at a shitty track in England. I don't like Silverstone, if you haven't fucking guessed. Anyways, off we go. 4 laps around the Grand Prix circuit. The now, old Grand Prix circuit. I should not have opened the bottom lane, because Johansson... Okay, not Johansson. Actually, that was Johansson. Never mind. Should have just stayed on the bottom, but no, it's fine. Oh my god! Why did you take that so fucking slow, Evans? Jesus Christ, in my asshole. Fucking hell. Okay, well, I got drivetrain damage and also steering damage, so... Gay AIDS. It's a good track. I'm not a fan of Silverstone. Especially the new layout. You know where this is the front straight? Well, I was gonna restart this race because of the steering damage, and it's like, yeah, no, I don't stand a chance in hell. Meanwhile, I just passed Rossi. And I do have a chance of catching Moore if I can fucking get this thing under control. Which, considering the steering damage, easier said than done. The blind AI Forza 4. Eh. I'd say it's more aggressive than blind. Although in the case of Evans, it was more, conservative, because he fucking stopped his car. In that first S-turn. First bend in the S. Is here. It's just like, fuck man, they slowed down so much. Evans slowed down even more than so. Oh, come on, Moore. Get that little Ferrari going. Yes, we all seen the Navy tweet from like forever ago. Man, you were way behind on news, Talos, aren't you? Son, you need to just climb out of that rock more often than every 5 months. Also, how the hell did I just make that pass? It just kind of happened. I don't know how it happened. Okay, well, I just nullified it anyways. Where are you? AI sometimes. Honestly, I don't have much troubles with the AI, except for Esposito. Esposito can go fuck his grandma. You know, I should have honestly broke a lot earlier than that. I should have, you know, expected that, but no. Just, no. Ooh, front end is at 100%. Oh yeah. Forza 6 damage. You know, either 0 or 100%. Mm-hmm. Still salty about that. Alright, well, let's try to drive this thing to victory. Don't know how well this is gonna go, but it's worth a shot. Well, Nürburgring GP first turn is a clusterfuck no matter what game you play. It's just the way the turn is designed. Like, there's not a single video game that has the fucking Nürburgring GP. In that form, where the first turn is not a clusterfuck. It's like, you just can't not, oh, fuck, no, anyways. Okay, that was shit right there. Some more to go to the outside. Where the hell did Rossi go? I just noticed he's falling back to fifth, it looks like. Also, I just kind of have the entire field on my ass here. I'm pretty sure I'm holding these guys up at this point with my car in this current state. Which honestly is not much of a surprise. No, please, no. Okay. Alright, just gotta hold him off for one more lap. Ooh, we're going super wide. Around the first corner. Oh, okay. Evans has somehow found his way into second now. Nice. That might actually be an issue because, you know, he's in a Koenigsegg, therefore big speed. Actually, no, that's Weber. Never mind. I saw blue and I assumed Evans in his Koenigsegg. No, it's Weber in, whatever the hell he's driving. MP4. Okay. Ooh. Careful, careful. Oh god, I'm fucking everything up. No! Russo? Russo? The fuck are you doing? I'm trying to take the lead. Fucking get the upset win. What the hell are you doing up here? You're a fucking backmarker, dude. Oh, god damn it. Everything is going wrong. I'm somehow still in the lead after, you know, mowing the lawn. No fucking clue how. Just keep a nice tight line, don't let anybody underneath me. Okay. Well. This race was absolutely fucking awful in every way, shape, and form. And yet I still won. I don't fucking know how. Really don't. It's just one of those things, it's one of those races where it's like, what the fuck happened? Also, Miller got shuffled all the way back to 7th on that last lap. Jesus Christ. That was just a fucking, that was a demo derby. That's what that was. Holy crap. Alright. Well, that should mean there's only one event left for this segment. Because we're reaching around 23 or 24, so, you know. Yeah.
Today you'll give the Nürburgring Grand Prix circuit another run.
Hey, speaking of the Nürburgring GP circuit, here we are at the Nürburgring GP circuit. And... you know what? Since I have level 4 affinity now with Selene, let's upgrade this thing to R3. Why not? Free upgrades. Ooh, can't quite reach 800. Or whatever, so... race this bitch out. Basically any track with a long stretch. Like a long run to the first turn, and the first turn being extremely tight. Is a massive clusterfuck. I like how the S5S is the cover car. Or the poster car for this series. Celine, yo. This, not the S7, the S5S. Oh. So, off we go to the Nürburgring Grand Prix circuit for our massive clusterfuck of a first turn. It's gonna be more of a clusterfuck for me because I'm starting on the outside. Because, you know, 6th position, or set, actually, unless it's a 10-car field, and I'm starting 7th. That's an 8-car field, 6th, okay. This is a very, varied field here. As far as, like, performance, this is unexpected. Okay. Hold on. Okay, attempt 2 at this race. Oh boy. I feel like this is going to be one of those races where, like, if I don't get into the lead, quickly, I don't have a shot. Because, that S7's kind of quick. Oh, 3 wide into turn 1. Around both of the other Raptors. Can I keep up with Davis? That is the question. Ooh. So I almost get destroyed by Taylor. Anyways, yeah, 1,000 horsepower, this car, oh boy, is it a handful. Even with this thing, like, trimmed out. I think this thing's fully upgraded, actually. Like, race everything, I have an itch. Okay. The itch took priority. Well, and my chair is fucking alright. Got a very careful around Schumacher S because I fucking hate this turn. Don't hit the back of Davis's car. Man. What a difference no damage makes. I'm actually able to keep up with Davis and also pass him. Oh, hey, Junior. So yeah, supercharger sound this thing. Not good for the ears. Alright, my current seating position is very fucked up. I kind of have the pop filter in my microphone covering about half of my playing screen. Thankfully, it's not like a solid object, so I can still, you know, I can see through it. But goddamn it, still impairing my vision. What's up? Oh, you know, just being very bad at driving this this insane car. Played some Doom earlier today. It's fucking great. Go car go. Around the hairpin. Oh, hello Davis, how you doing? This is not a good idea. Please, please don't do this. Not in the Schumacher S. She's TCS? No. I play with zero assists. Because it makes it more fun. I didn't say I don't want to fucking drive this thing. I'm just saying, this thing's an insane beast. Honestly, it makes it more fun to drive. And stressful, but more fun. It's like, hey, throttle control is a thing I have to do. And steering control, and just, yeah. Seem very relaxed right now. No, not really. You know, I'm kind of trying to tame a 1,000 horsepower monster while a Selena 7 breathes down my ass. You know. Just Forza things. Oh, I'm not making this turn. Hi. Whoa, hey, Davis. Okay, you brought that upon yourself. Nope. Mm-mm. I'm not to blame for that one. Oh, yeah, I'm listening to the Doom soundtrack also, Junior. I had so much fun playing, I don't want to let the music now. Yeah, blind as fuck. Eh, not really. Like, I can't really, like, you know, be like, oh, they can't program AI awareness to that one. Because, like, I was super fucking wide. You know, like, of all the places for him to get a super run on me off of that hairpin, it's just the worst spot, because that means we're just, yeah, that's happening. Fucking Schumacher S shenanigans. Oh, goddammit. Schumacher S shenanigans. cool. Getting damage on my car, which is going to make it slower. Make Davis even more difficult to deal with. Make it into the chicane. Nice and good. Nice schmoove. Okay, one lap to go. Can I hold off Davis for one more lap? Okay, Forza 6 is a completely different animal. They just forgot how to program AI, like the intelligence part of artificial intelligence in Forza 5 and 6. This game, you know. This game, the AI is actually not bad. It might not be as good as like 2 and 3, but you know. It's not the absolute drizzling shits. Okay. How's this hairpin gonna go this time? Can I get a better exit this time? Ooh. Careful with the throttle. Okay. Don't have to worry about going fucking door to door into the Schumacher S. Why did I fucking climb the curb? It's a very bad idea. Drifting. Drifting. Drifting in general, shit. Stay behind me, Davis. God damn it. No bad. Okay. Davis, I swear to God. Listen here, you fucker. No, no, no. You're not spoiling this victory for me. Come on the throttle. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Well, Jesus Christ, that was a race. That was a nice race, actually. Whew. That was absolutely insane. And it was kind of pretty fucking good. Pretty fucking fun. Of course, you know, and there's the other Celines we kind of have to wait on finishing, because they're a lower class, so... say about drifting. Said drifting is fucking, well, I can't say drifting is shit. It's just the community is shit. I'm not a fan of drifting, though. Not at all. I'm just like, drifting, alright, cool, I'd rather race. I'd rather go around a turn quickly than sideways. But that's just me. And my shit opinions. Come on, Jones, cross the line. You're already a minute behind me. Come the fuck on. How are you so far behind Anderson? What happened between you two? Like, Jones, did you break your car off of Anderson's ass? Something tells me that he did. I have a feeling that he did. Okay, well, that was one insane fucking race. I almost got a double level up out of that from the bonus. Double affinity level up, but nope. So, that just leaves one more event left in the championship series. You should know what it's going to be. It's going to be a world championship event, so...
Today, we're back at the legendary Le Mans Circuit de la Sarthe in France.
Ooh, we're gonna do it at Circuit de la Sarthe. Ooh, alrighty. Well, we will take care of that in the next segment, so... That was quite an adventure with this car. So with that, stay tuned for more Forza 4 and the Championship Series finale.